Hello and a very warm welcome to Rajya Sabha Television. You're watching Security Scan. I'm Frank Rausen Pereira. Well, Indian Navy's fifth Scorpene submarine, Vagir, having superior stealth features like advanced acoustic absorption technique, was launched last week at the Mazagaon dock in South Mumbai. INS Vagir is part of the six Kalvari class submarines being built in India. The submarines designed by French Naval Defence and Energy Company DCNS are being built as part of the Indian Navy's Project 75. These submarines can undertake missions like anti-surface warfare, anti-submarine warfare, intelligence gathering, mine laying and area surveillance is what the official release said. Vagir is named after the sandfish, a deadly deep sea predator of the Indian Ocean. The first Vagir, a submarine from Russia, was commissioned into the Indian Navy on December 3, 1973 and was decommissioned on June 7, 2001 after almost three decades of service to the nation. The submarine is designed to operate in all theatres of operation, showcasing interoperability with other components of a naval task force. In this edition of Security Scan, we will analyze the benefits and strategic importance of INS Vagir. Joining me on the program today are Vice Admiral Satish Soni, retired, former Commander-in-Chief of the Southern and Eastern Command, Lieutenant General Dr. V.K. Saxena, retired, Distinguished Fellow, Vivekananda International Foundation, and Commander Abhijit Singh, retired, Head, Maritime Policy Initiative, Observer Research Foundation. Thank you to all my guests for joining me on this edition of Security Scan. Admiral, I'd like to begin the program with you first. Let's first try and understand the salient features of INS Vagir.
you know, the importance of Vagir lies in the fact that it has been indigenously constructed and built in the Mazagaon Docks Limited. This is a part of the Scorpene program, which was conceived in 2000. The contract was signed in 2005, and we were hoping that the first submarine would join us in 2012 or so. But then there were some delays on account of contract complications, and the first one was commissioned in 2017. Two have already been commissioned, and the third one is likely to be commissioned this year. And Vagir is the one which has been launched. Now, there's a difference between launching a submarine and commissioning a submarine. Launching means, you know, the first time when the hull touches the water, and then the submarine gets outfitted and it's finally commissioned, you know, when it starts sailing and joins the fleet. So hopefully by 2024, we will have the project completed, and all the six submarines would have joined the Indian Navy. Now, it is a submarine which has been designed by the French. It's a modern submarine. So therefore, you could say that everything that goes into the making of a submarine is good. It's got, better, a more modern system, like the integrated platform management system, the torpedo control system. It has got a better indiscretion rate, which means, you know, the time that it spends underwater and the time that it spends above water charging its batteries, the ratios are, more advantageous. It has got an advanced acoustic absorption technique on the hull to provide better stealth features. Its radiated noise levels are much lower than the other submarines that we have had. It's the design itself of the hull is better, gives better hydrodynamically optimized shape, so that, you know, it can get better speeds and it can address the sonar waves that are thrown at us in a better manner. And of course, most important is that it's got better missiles and better torpedoes, and of course a better underwater signature. So all in all, you can say that it's one of the best conventional submarines that we have in the world today. A number of nations are operating this submarine, And Mazagon Docks has developed this expertise to build these submarines, which also means that, you know, it has a fairly good indigenous content, about 35% to 40%. And so that's it.
Okay. All right. So those were the benefits and the features, really, as far as INS Vagir is concerned. General, let me come to you now and let's talk about, you know, something a little different than the submarine itself. Let's not forget that the submarine has been built in collaboration with the French. What does it say about our relationship, our strategic partnership with the French? And you know, can we see more coordination and, you know, more collaboration between Indian and the French navies as well as a whole?
Yeah, the collaboration between the two navies is going great, as also the collaboration with other countries are also on a high keel. More important than just the collaboration is what has been our standing relationship in building these six submarines, Scorpion class submarines, and what technologies that Satish was just trying to bring out have come about. And that actually brings out what is the strategic significance of this submarine which is coming to us. Now, if I were to not talk about Vagir as just one submarine in a narrow perspective and look at a larger picture of the strategic significance of the submarine, then I'll take you back right back to 1997-99, when just around the Kargil war and thereabout, a decision was taken to make a 30-year program for building submarines, which ends in 2030. And it talked about that time 24 submarines. And initial days, one was thinking of six submarines in the eastern water stream, six of the western stream technology, and 12 indigenous. But as the time rolled by, and we came to December 2019, the Navy presented a report to the parliament in which they talked about 24 submarines, in which six have to be nuclear powered and 18 have to be conventional submarines. Now, we are today operating one nuclear ballistic submarine and one nuclear attack submarine and 12 other submarines. So look at Vagir. It makes an addition. Now, not only just number addition, it is not numbers alone. Not talking of the nuclear submarines, against the requirement of six, we have two, one leased, one indigenous, Ariane, and the other one is still a gap of four. Whereas the other two types of submarine, leave aside the Scorpion class, I'm talking of the Shishumar class, or I'm talking of the Sindhu Ghosh class, these types of submarine, four and eight in number, are vintage submarines now, because they are vintages 17 to 23 years of vintage today. And this submarine, which Admiral was just bringing out, brings out not only the technologies of the 2020s, it also brings out the futuristic technology. He was talking about the acoustic silencing signature, low radiation signature, hydrodynamically operated optimized shape, and the capability to use precision guided munition. Most important, the munition which is being talked about is the anti-torpedo countermeasure system. It has got additional electronic warfare muscle in terms of a countermeasure, anti-torpedo countermeasures. It has got an endurance of 50 days. It has got, now if you take the other submarines, they are of the speed of 11 knots, 10 knots. Here it is doing a speed of 20 nautical miles. Now that is a good speed. It is also using best of weapon system. So with French collaboration and this sort program, which is of course 6 to 8 years delayed today, is going great, is inducting not only technology, it is also fighting our vintage. It is also looking after or making the requirement, some part making the requirement of the Project 75, which talks about 24 submarines.
Absolutely. All right. So, Abhijit Singh, let's talk about the strategic importance then of the Scorpion class of submarines as well as INS Vagir in particular.
Yeah, so Frank, one of the reasons why SSKs or subsurface killers, the conventional submarines, are so much in discussion, they elicit so much of a debate, is basically because any seagoing navy or a navy with blue water aspirations requires submarines that can fight in the littorals or that can fight in the shallow waters. So whilst there has been a lot of talk about there being, you know, nuclear submarines, the fact that SSBNs today in the new strategic matrix are so important, I would say that a lot of navies these days are giving a lot of importance to SSKs or diesel electric submarines. And one of the reasons for that is that a diesel electric submarine is much cheaper than a nuclear submarine. It is it has greater maneuverability in shallow waters. And even though it does not have the range that, you know, a nuclear submarine might have, but a diesel electric submarine can achieve so much more in shallow water warfare. So so when you talk of the balance between adversaries, you want a submarine that can do both offense and defense. So there is the SSK that, you know, can protect own assets in the near seas, but it could also attack our adversaries in their shallow waters. So in that sense, it's very important to have an SSK. I would say that the fact that, you know, after a lag of nearly 5 or 6 years, you know, this project, the Scorpion class, was due to be delivered by 2015-16, it's now 2020. So this has been delayed by what, 4 or 5 years. But the fact that we have in quick succession, commissioned stroke launched 4 or 5 of these, 5 actually of these submarines is something that we have to be something for us to be proud of. And yet I would say that we need to be cautious in our optimism about this particular project because one, this has been delayed. Second, it also, some of these submarines also don't have their primary weapon, which is the Black Shark torpedo, and there is a whole discussion around that. You know, these submarines will only have the Exocet missile, which has limited in range, and also the fact that, you know, some of these submarines really need to be improved in a way that. That we have not seen happen in the past few years, in the sense that when the initial submarines got commissioned, there were a number of defects that had been reported, and I hope that in the case of the later submarines, at least the third or the fourth submarine, and perhaps even this submarine, once it goes in for sea trials, that problem of those defects that were with the engine noise, the propeller noise, would have been sorted out. So right. I say that this is something; these are cheery tidings. We need to be happy about them. But all the same, we need to have a degree of caution in our optimism about this particular project.
Absolutely. All right. So, Admiral, let's also talk about the aspect of, you know, what goes into building one of these submarines and how is Vagir different from the rest of the Scorpion class submarines?
We are a young navy. And our founding fathers had two main aims in building our Navy. One is that it should be three-dimensional. That means we should have the capability of fighting in all domains, that is the surface domain, underwater, and in the air. And the second and the more important one was that we should be self-reliant. Now, whilst we had a very good surface building program for surface ships, and we even imported an aircraft carrier in 1962, and we have one building right now, the first one. Somehow, our capability to build conventional submarines has not been as good. We first imported the Foxtrot class submarines in 1968. Eight of them from Soviet Union. That was the first time that we acquired the submarines. And then we had the Kilo class, 10 of them coming in from the Soviet Union. And then we had STW submarines, 4 of them. That is 2 plus 2. 2 were to be imported and 2 were built in the MDL. Regrettably, that contract ran into a controversy. And with that, our ability to build submarines indigenously also got put off. So then the Scorpion program, as you know, has fructified, but the indigenous content is not very high. But in the meantime, our strategic program, that is of building the SSBNs, did pretty well. And we are the only country which was able to build the SSBN without actually going in for a SSN first. And we took us 25 years, but today we have INS Arihant, which is operational. So it is a bit strange that whilst our ability to build strategic submarines, which is more difficult, is pretty honed, but in conventional submarines, we have got a lag behind. Right. But now we have a program that is 75 India, which is on the anvil. The RFP is going to be floated soon. It is on a strategic partnership basis. With MOD, a foreign collaborator, and either the MDL or the LNT being partners. And we should hopefully see a new line of submarines, which is going to come about. And the Scorpion submarines, the new submarines would be bigger than the Vagir class of submarines. Vagir and the other class of submarines, they are exactly the same. All the six submarines are the same. There was an intention by the Navy to include the air independent propulsion system in the later class of submarines, but that has not, the indigenous system has not got developed as yet. So hopefully we should see in the 75 India this system coming about. But right. As it stands, you know, all the three submarines are the same.
Thank okay. You. All right, General. So what does it mean for the Indian Navy, you know, getting all these new Scorpion class of submarines either commissioned or launched?
While the Admiral has already brought out the sequence of the Scorpion class submarine coming up, and he very interestingly brought out that starting from Kalwari to Khanderi to Karanj to Vela to Vagir to Vakshir, whenever their names have been taken from the same submarines which were held initially, they're the submarines which India held from 1967 to 2001, different time. And Vela is one submarine which actually was the oldest submarine of 37 years service where it was decommissioned. My problem is not on Scorpion. My problem is something else. My issue and my challenge and concern is the maintenance and upkeep of the submarines which are now badly aging. Now, there was a media report long time back that the mid-refit life certification, which is in short called the MRLC, of a number of submarines of the Sindhu Coast class is held up because the problems of, you know, procurement, bank guarantee, this, that, and the other. As also Satish already brought out a fact that the problem of the HTW submarine is the spare support and maintenance after they have been commissioned to make these submarines, because all the 24 submarines cannot be changed overnight. Even if we change these, it's going to take a long time. So the biggest problem is how to maintain 8 of Sindhu Ghosh and 4 of Sishumar class submarine is the issue with these two. And the more important issue is, you everybody now talks of Project 75 India and what all and everything else is going hanky-dory. But I will take you back to 2000. We are 20 years into this hacking. From 2008 onwards, I remember when I was in the procurement arena in my own service domain, there was any number of issues of RFI getting issued, RFP getting issued, getting retracted, this, that, and the other. And now DSC on 21st January 2020 has finally said, all right, enough is enough. MDL and LNT on the Indian side and 5 manufacturers of the foreign origin, French, German, Russian, are going to make this 75I6 submarines possible in Make in India concept. Mm. Now, that is a wishful thinking as of 20th January 2020. We have to make this happen. This program, after 30 years of its runtime, is coming to a close in 9 years from now, 2030. And we are at the phase out of this program, talking about 75I. And remember, as I told you in the earlier also, what is Navy's requirement? 24 submarines, 6 nuclear powered, and 18 other. Now, 18 plus 6, 24. Where are we? We are one leased, one SSBN of our own, and 14 of that in which 8 plus 4, Sindhu Ghosh and Shishumar are old and aging, and six new, two commissioned, two in the sea trials, and the fourth one still getting ready to be booked.
Right.
This is issue. This is the bigger picture. For Navy, the submarine picture is not yet very rosy. There are long, long gaps to be covered. We are talking about Wagir and its strategic significance. Let us talk about, instead of strategic significance, strategic challenges for the submarine force of the Indian Navy.
Absolutely. So a lot more to go really as far as the submarines of the Indian Navy are concerned is what the general is suggesting. Abhijit Singh, let me bring you into the picture now. Let's also talk about why are submarines required really as far as our Navy is concerned. And now with these new submarines either commissioned or launched, how do we fare or compare to other navies?
You raise a very important point, Frank, and this is where strategic balance, you know, the emerging strategic picture comes in. The fact is that the Chinese and the Pakistanis are principal, so to say, adversaries in the Indo-Pacific region. Pakistan more in the Indian Ocean, but you know, in a sort of broader context, China are giving a lot of attention to the development of conventional submarines. We know for a fact that the Pakistanis are going to have in the next few years about 8 Type 39 Yuan class from China. And there are plans to install the Babur missile on some of these submarines that the Pakistanis will acquire. The Chinese themselves have been working on their Yuan class. They have, as we know, the Ming class, and you know, there's the other classes of conventional submarines that they have. But again, the Chinese are also paying a lot of focus to the development of cruise missiles. And Pakistanis too. This is another area that they're increasingly sort of interested in. So as far as India is concerned, this broader strategic balance of power is something that that New Delhi must consider in the development of the submarine program. And here, I mean, I couldn't agree more with what the general has just pointed to, the fact that, you know, we've got something called the P-75 India program, but the fact is that it's making very slow and tardy progress. These RFIs that he talks about, and he rightly points out, have been floated at least two or three times in the past. And somehow the rules of engagement keep changing. There is a sense that there is no clarity on what the strategic partnership model is actually going to be. There have been some dockyards identified, you know, there's MDL, there's LNT, etc. But how exactly are we going to go about doing it? The DPP 2020 that has just been sort of released, or there's talk about the DPP 2020, but even there is little clarity on how exactly we will move forward. So I think that, again, in a strategic framework, submarines are important. Our adversaries are developing them. We should have them. But it is dismaying to see that, you know, we ourselves have very little idea of what exactly the path is going to be once we get these six Scorpion-class submarines commissioned. How are we going to get the follow-on class? How exactly are we going to move ahead on that? And one last point that I think is important that needs to be sort of mentioned here is that we've got to search for balance between the private sector and the public sector. My sense is, even I'm not someone that's so much into submarine building, but one thing that I recognize is that, and a lot of other analysts recognize, is that we've not been able to find a balance between the private and the public sector. We've tended to prioritize the public sector, thinking that, you know, MDHEL has all these assets and resources and experience and expertise in doing this, so let's just go ahead with them. Whereas the private sector also has developed considerable capability, and somehow we've got to, you know, trust the private sector also when it comes to submarine building. So I think there are challenges before us when it comes to the submarine building program.
Absolutely. All right, time now to get a quick closing comment from the Admiral with the best way forward. And what next?
Well, I would shortlist 3 points. One is, we've got to go ahead at a faster pace for the 75 India and make sure that there is more indigenous content in these submarines, just like what we have achieved in the warships. Second, MDL has developed a lot of expertise while building these Scorpion submarines. this must not go waste. Either we should start a line, another line, or we should develop some, make it as a manufacturing hub of the submarine. The submarines are very popular amongst other countries. Maybe we can start building for the others. Maybe we can start repairing, etc. And the third point that I want to say is that we have a head start in making of nuclear reactors. INS Ariant is a SSBN with a small reactor. We could build slightly bigger reactors and make SSNs, which are faster, quicker, and have more capabilities than the conventional submarines. The indigenous content in our SSBNs is going to reach maybe 85-90%. By the time we reach the fourth or the fifth one, it's going to be completely indigenous. So this head start that we have got should not get lost. And this capability must get converted into more SSNs, submarines, which are smaller in size,
right,
with bigger reactors and more powerful. Thank you.
Okay. All right. On that note, then, I'll call it a wrap on this edition of Security Scan. Thank you to all my guests for joining me on the program and putting things into perspective for us. That's it from me. See you again next time.